The second book has just been published by Dutton. It is called Reaching to Heaven, A Spiritual Journey Through Life and Death. There you see its cover. About his first book, Talking to Heaven, remember when James von Praagh made his first major appearance was on this program. He has now become world famous. Newsweek said, there is a great spiritual hunger in America. Von Praagh shows us how eager each of us is to find some measure of transcendence as we make our way through this world. He has changed people's lives, banished the fear of death, brought grieving parents the solace of their dead children's presence. It's impossible not to be moved. How much of you do you think is, we want to believe you? Which gives you an edge going in. We want you to be right.
I think everyone wants me to be right. That's what I think. I think everyone is yearning, everyone wants something, everyone wants to hear something they can relate to. And sure, that goes.
Therefore, so when there are the skeptics who accuse you of being a charlatan, one of the edges any charlatan has is they want to believe.
Sure.
Cure me of my disease.
That's right. That's right. Well, it all comes down to a matter of belief and everyone's truth. Because skeptics have their truth, and they have their right to express themselves the way they choose. And everyone has an awareness. That's their awareness. And my work isn't necessarily for everyone, and it's not meant to be. It resonates with those who it's meant to resonate with, and the thousands of people that it's helped and transformed their lives. That's what it's about. It's not about the skeptics.
By logic, shouldn't every religious leader in the world salute you? You, after all, are saying what the Bible says. We go on.
You know, Larry, I think it's not me. It's spirit. And they shouldn't salute me. They should salute spirit. Because...
Well, certainly they shouldn't put you down.
No. They should be really respectful. Because they're respecting spirit, the work of spirit. Okay, I'm just the instrument. I'm just the telephone.
Can you briefly explain, because you cover a lot in this book that we didn't cover before.
Right.
What you do?
Basically, I'm a medium, which means in between. Everything being energy, okay, vibrating at certain rates of speed. I'm someone who is able to, just like a radio station, tune into the various frequencies of spirit world. And it's like hearing soundless words. I'm able to pick up thoughts and feelings from the people who have left this physical world behind.
Only
and
from
have gone
family
home.
Members?
Oh, no, from family members.
But you couldn't pick up Lincoln for me, right?
No, what I have found with my work is I need to have, there needs to be a tie, a bond with the person and the spirit person. There has to be that bond. Just like for, you know, I don't know Elvis Presley, so I wouldn't begin to have a connection with Elvis Presley unless I was sitting with a family member.
But sometimes radio generators break down.
That's
cells
right.
die.
That's
Who
right.
or what are you communicating with?
Well, I am communicating with what I believe is the soul of that person, or an essence of that soul, a part of the personality which survives death. See, death is just the physical world. It's just a physical world. We need to go through life really having a conscious immortality, meaning that we are always alive. We always have been alive. We always will be alive. There is no such thing as death.
All right, in this extraordinary book, you describe things like what happens when you die.
The process
like,
of death.
What does happen?
Well, I bring people through the process of death, through the thousands of readings that I've done, the experiences that I've had. I share them with the people. And I talk about the spirit leaving the body, exiting the body.
Is it a happy moment?
The common thread in most of the exiting times I've had has been one of joy, peace, an overwhelming sense of lightness that people have. And then there's a sense of an expansion of awareness that they also have.
Absence of pain in the other world?
Absence of pain because it's a physical trait, you see. It's of the physical.
How on earth can you describe heaven?
Well,
I mean, what do you base that on?
Well, you can call heaven, you can use heaven or the summerland or the hereafter, any idiom you'd like to for that description of that place. It is our home. We are first and foremost spiritual beings. We come from spirit. That is our place. Just like on this earth, there are many different areas. There are slums, there are wealthy areas, there are all different levels of places.
But all that's in the physical.
In the physical. In the spirit, there is also levels of soul awareness, places, which they could be physical places, where you go to, where you actually will gravitate to, depending upon your spiritual evolution.
So heaven is many things.
As the Bible says, my father has a house with many mansions.
How do you know this?
How do I know this? I only base it on the readings that I've done, 15 years of readings, And I've done many.
So these are people,
hundreds of books I've read also.
No longer in the physical form, communicating with you, telling you what it's like. Even though they're not in a physical form.
Right. Their experiences is what I tell about. I also, you know, it's very interesting because I grew up a skeptic. I was very skeptical of this whole thing before I started doing this. Didn't believe a word of it until I was awakened, if you would. Mm-hmm.
Is there a hell?
There is a hell. There's a heaven and hell, but it's not as the religious,
not a burning place.
Not a religious sense of heaven or hell. Just like there are good and bad on this earth, the place in spirit, there are many levels of good and bad. And it's really a reflection of the person themselves, of what they create.
Do we come back?
We do come back. There is reincarnation, because this is our schoolroom, and we come back here to learn lessons.
But if we don't know we were here once, how can I apply the lesson?
Because it's ingrained in your soul memory, your soul knowledge. We come back and we build up our souls. We build up the fabric of the soul with all the experiences we have. See? And that's what happens, and we grow. It's like, if you compare it to a home, having a home, coming back to a house each time, and the house gets nicer and bigger and each time you come back. And through each time of coming back, there's experiences that help you to grow and expand your awareness.